In this video, I will show you how easy it is to create a virtual colleague that works around the clock, always stays friendly and professional, and can answer questions in 28 different languages.
I'm Brian, here to help with your IT questions and issues. How can I assist you?
I'm creating this virtual colleague with a new tool from Heygen. It's called Interactive Avatar. This tool allows you to create a virtual assistant that you can train with specific knowledge, and you can use it for answer customer questions, providing training, or even acting as a help desk. Let's dive into the setup process. First of all, you can start using this tool with just a free account. Just log in and click on Labs to access the Interactive Avatar tool, and click on Public Avatars. The first step is to create a knowledge base for our new virtual colleague. Just paste relevant URLs that you want to use as source for your knowledge base. In this example, I already pasted the link to the Microsoft 365 training site. This site has all the information your avatar will need to answer questions about Microsoft 365. You also need to fill in an opening intro text. And this is the text that our avatar will be saying when opening the chat. The next step is to write a prompt. In this example, I've asked ChatGPT to write me a prompt, and as you can see, it says to keep things simple and easy to understand. Next step is to choose an avatar. So in this case, I will select public avatars. Then select the knowledge base you want to work with. Pick an avatar you like. In this case, it's about getting help with IT questions, so it might be good to select an avatar behind a computer. Here we have Silas, who works for computer support or customer support. Let's pick this guy. This screen pops up and you see that you can select the language. In this case, let's leave it at English and then start a new chat.
Welcome. I'm here to help you explore and learn about Microsoft 365. Let's make your work easier and more productive.
Hi, I have a question. Next week I'm off and enjoying a short vacation. How can I set my out-of-office message?
Setting an out-of-office message in Outlook is easy. Here's how to do it step by step. And for Outlook on Windows, 1, open Outlook. Launch the Outlook application on your computer. 2, go to File. Click on the File tab in the top left corner. 3, select Automatic Replies. Click on Automatic Replies out of office. 4, turn on automatic replies. In the dialog box that appears, select send automatic replies. Enjoy your vacation.
Okay, thank you. I'm really impressed what this tool can do, to be honest. Of course, it cannot do all the things that an actual support desk employee in most cases can, like taking over my screen, for example. But it will improve over time and probably will be able to show the end user screenshots or instructional videos to make it easier for the end user to understand how to fix things. For now, this could be an additional colleague that can help your customers or end users outside of business hours, for example. Now, let's try another use case as well. Since Heygen has these doctor's avatars, let's try to create a medical knowledge base. As you can see, I've already created this knowledge base by adding two URLs. The first one is Medline Plus, which is an American health information resource for patients. And I also tried to add a Dutch resource, which is called Thuisarts, and that's translated home doctor. And Heygen accepted both resources, even though that one of them was in Dutch. So I think that's pretty impressive already. Now, I also asked ChatGPT to write me a prompt for this knowledge base. And you see that he created a lot of details like name, age, background, etc. I'm not sure how important that is exactly, but it might help to get better results. Okay, so now let's pick the first avatar here and see how that will work.
Hi. I'm your virtual health assistant, ready to answer your health questions. Let's explore the info you need together.
Hi, I have a problem with my shoulder. During a game of padel, I hurt my shoulder. That was 7 months ago, and it still hurts. Especially when I lift my arm, stretch it, and trying to grab something, I feel an itching pain in my shoulder. What could be the cause, and what kind of treatment would you recommend here?
Hello. I'm sorry to hear about your shoulder pain. That sounds quite uncomfortable. Based on your description, it might be related to a few common shoulder issues, such as a rotator cuff injury, tendonitis, or bursitis. These conditions can cause pain, especially with movement, and may persist if not adequately treated. Here are some general approaches to consider for treatment. 1. Rest. Avoid activities that aggravate the pain, especially lifting or reaching overhead. 2. Ice therapy. Applying ice to the shoulder for 15 to 20 minutes several times a day can help reduce swelling and pain. 3. Over-the-counter pain relief. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs like ibuprofen, can help manage pain and inflammation. 4. Physical therapy. A physical therapist can provide exercises to strengthen the shoulder and improve its range of motion. 5. Gradual return to activity. Once your pain decreases, gradually return to your activities, but be mindful not to push too hard too quickly.
Also very realistic, I would say. Not bad at all. I recently experienced shoulder pains myself, and the avatar's response closely matches my real doctor's advice. Now, Heygen offers more functionality within this tool, like sharing a link that you can send to people. Just click on Share Avatar here and make sure to select the correct knowledge base. And then just click Copy Link. You can share this link with anyone. They don't have to have an account or log into Heygen to be able to use this. Another option that I think might be interesting to use is the integrate option. With this, you can integrate this chat window to your website, and this is how it looks like when you do that. And that's what I wanted to show you about this promising tool from Heygen. We've created two virtual colleagues that can answer questions and provide support. If you are excited about potential of Heygen's interactive avatars, give this video a like, subscribe for more tips, and let me know in the comments how you would use an avatar in your work. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.